It's Christmas time!
In this mini-series, we're going to take an intimate look at Norwegian Christmas traditions, filmed as they happened in 2019. You'll get to see how Norwegians prepare for Christmas and how they celebrate Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and New Year's Eve. Before we begin, I should mention that Norwegians are very reserved and shy about being on camera, so we'll use lots of close-ups and occasionally blur faces. However, you'll still get a fascinating insight into Norwegian culture and you'll have a virtual seat at the table as we feast on Christmas food.
Ankomst til Norge.
We start our journey at Oslo Airport Gardermoen. In Norway, the sales tax is 25% on goods and 15% on food. So when returning home, it's common for Norwegians to pick up alcohol and cigarettes at the duty-free shop. Norway is an expensive, expensive country.
You get three of these for 25 quid.
The taxes are high, which means the wages are high, which means the price of goods and services are high. It's great if you're Norwegian, but not so great if you're from abroad. You can scrape by on £50 a day by staying in a hostel and self-catering, but expect to fork out over £100 a day if you want a hotel room, and an eye-watering £200 a day if you want to eat out at decent places.
Time to go home!
The first things you'll notice about Norway are how clean it is and how quiet it is. Norway has a population of 5.4 million spread over 365,000 square kilometers, which makes it slightly larger than Germany.
Some people are always old.
This works out to a population density of about 15 people per square kilometer. For reference, England's density is 432 people per square kilometer, which is 28 times higher. The public transport system is frequent in the cities but can be infrequent in rural areas. However, they're almost always on time. Over the course of 4 years, even while staying in a remote village on the west coast, I've never waited more than 2 minutes for a local bus.
We're in Drammen, my hometown. I'm gonna show you guys around. Love this chair.
Drammen is a river city at the end of a fjord, and yes, that's how they decorate Christmas trees here. It has a population of 100,000 people, making it the sixth largest urban area in Norway. Like many European towns, there's a public square surrounded by shops, hotels, restaurants, and leisure facilities. This neo-Gothic church was built in 1871 and faces the town square, with an impressive view. Drammen is famous for having the oldest surviving brewery in Norway, Aas Brewery, founded in 1834. Other sights to see are Ypsilon Bridge and Spiralentoppen, a spiral road tunnel that climbs to the edge of the valley with incredible views over the city. We made our way to my sister-in-law's place, where we would take part in our first pre-Christmas tradition.
Julebakst.
Or Christmas baking.
Every Sunday before Christmas, we have four Sundays, and they're called Advent Sundays. We light a candle every Sunday and wait for it to burn down, basically counting down to Christmas, and we bake. Every day should be a baking day, especially when there are so many goodies. And I'm so proud of my baby sister because she made loads of things with help of her mother-in-law. She burned something, but we're gonna leave that out.
Traditionally, Norwegians will bring their family together and bake seven different items. As we near Christmas, the 23rd of December is called
Lille Julaften,
where Norwegians gather and put the finishing touches to the decorations. They also watch an English sketch called Dinner for One that was filmed in the 1960s in Germany. It's unknown in the UK, but practically everybody knows it in Norway.
Tell me, dear sister, yeah. What did you make today?
This is being bad your accounts.
Yeah.
This is caramel shakes. This is silkekake. And this is kokosmakroner.
Juleinnkjøp av matvarer.
Norwegian supermarkets are smaller in size and product selection than their British and American counterparts because of the lower population.
Country of potatoes. You can cook it, you can fry it, and you can make a mash out of it.
Almonds.
Yeah, almond potatoes. Is it shaped like an almond, I guess? But they're the classic potatoes for parties.
You'll come across several familiar brands. However, during Christmas, Norwegians lose their collective minds and prefix Yule in front of everything you can imagine. You'll find Christmas crisps, Christmas cake, Christmas ale, and even Christmas vegetables.
Alright, we have our own Christmas drink for Christmas, and it's called Julebrus. It's brewed in a local brewery, so we have to have this every Christmas, next to our Christmas dinner. Okay, this is a Christmas drink in Norway. It's called Tomtegrøgg. We usually have this with chopped up almond bits in it.
It's my favorite dessert in all of Norway.
Julepynt shopping.
Outside of Oslo, Norwegian towns and cities don't have what we would describe as a high street. So for clothes, groceries and Christmas present shopping, Norwegians flock to the shopping malls.
I'm gonna try Hjort, which is the deer for Rudolph. But a very tasty Rudolph!
According to a 2018 Ipsos survey, each household will spend £1,040 on Christmas celebrations, spending £520 on gifts alone. Us Brits aren't slouches though. Even though we earn half of what they earn, we spend almost as much. £973 in total, with £530 spent on gifts. The
Julestjerne,
or Christmas star, is the most popular Christmas plant. It's worth noting that what you're seeing aren't vibrant red flower petals, they're actually leaves. It's also common for Norwegians to hang illuminated cardboard Christmas stars in their windows. The only reason you'll notice this is because they don't use net curtains here.
Jul I Oslo.
Oslo is Norway's capital city, which was founded over 1,000 years ago. In Norwegian, it's pronounced
Oslo,
or if you're posh,
Oslo.
It was previously known as Christiania, and recently it was nicknamed Tiger City. Oslo is often cited as the fastest growing city in Europe, generating an enormous 25% of Norway's GDP. Its high quality of life is matched by its reputation for regularly ranking as one of the most expensive cities to live in. The metropolitan area of Oslo has a population of just over 1.5 million inhabitants, meaning 27% of the entire population of Norway lives either in or around the city. The population is diverse, 25% of Oslo's population foreign-born and a further 7.8% being from an immigrant background. Like many European capitals, Oslo isn't very representative of Norwegian culture, until Christmas, when the city comes alive with dazzling Christmas lights and cozy Christmas markets.
Back in the day, or even some place in Norway now, you can use something like this for transportation. One person sits at the front while the other one is doing the hard work, sliding through, using their leg force to get through the snow and ice. We're also right now exploring the Christmas market here. And there are loads of food stalls here, it's buzzing, people are walking all over each other here. We have a Ferris wheel and a ice rink. Lots of people falling over, which is a lot of fun to see. Now let's go and explore the stalls.
Merry Christmas, Alfred.
The Swedish Chippendales are here, selling smelting in Norway.
Smelting
Chippendales.
Yeah. So I'm gonna try some smelting in. It's donuts, but dried on without the glaze or anything, but it's full of fat. And it's really nice to have this in this cold weather because it's gonna heat you from the inside. And don't tell anyone, they're actually Swedish. Mm, so yummy. Oh my God!
Julebord.
which translates to Christmas table, is a Christmas party that's usually organized by companies or organizations. According to Oskar and Stalin's website, in 1971 it opened its doors as the first steak restaurant in Drammen and one of the first restaurants to offer pizza. We're here to try traditional Norwegian food and
Akevitt,
a Scandinavian spirit usually distilled from potatoes and flavored with spices. It's usually 40% alcohol by volume and it's drunk at Christmas because it's believed to aid digestion.
It looks worse than it is. So this is my personal favorite. It's from the town next door, Lye.
That's nice though.
Yeah. So it works great with like mussels and stuff. Then we have the Amundsen, which is like the well.
Definitely. It goes up the nose, that does.
Oh yeah. If you smell it while you have a runny nose, you're
Cleared out.
You're fine. This is the one that I drink at Christmas Eve. So like steak. No, not steak, but pork belly.
Oh god.
It smells like nail polish remover. It's made
in
Norway.
It's illegal to make it, home.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It's, don't do that.
And that was the mild one?
And that was the mild one. That is the mildest, kindest one.
Wait, the aftertaste is good. It has licorice flavor.
Really?
Yeah, they use a lot of spices.
Oh wow. You know we love our potatoes when we make liquor out of it. Cheers, guys! No, not again.
Lutefisk
is made by drying white fish, soaking it in water, curing it in a caustic soda solution, soaking it again in water, and then serving it alongside bacon, peas, and potatoes.
I'm really excited because I'm going to try lutefisk for the very first time. Most Norwegians are terrified of this item because it's supposed to be... My mom, when she came to Norway for the first time, she had lutefisk and it was a terrible experience for her. She thought, if this is like their Christmas dinner, how will the regular food taste like? This time it's gonna be so exciting to see her reaction. Bon appétit!
Okay.
It's okay, but it's better than the last time you had it. Mm. I think I actually like it a lot. Wow!
That's so salty. That is super salty.
If I just have the fish myself, it's so slippery. It has actually a little bit jelly texture to it, but it's so good.
I see why you need the aquavit to wash it down.
Aquavit?
That's water, not aquavit.
Juletallerken
is the name given to a plate of traditional Norwegian Christmas food. It usually consists of
julepølse med disterkake
and
ribbe.
It's a celebration in your mouth.
Christmas sausage. Julepølse. But to me, it tastes like a regular sausage. What makes it jule sausage?
It is made from. I'm
in the traditional
way, but they have also
sort of
little spices as well.
Nice.
This one, I think.
Like the regular hot dogs aren't that dense.
Meaty flavors, meaty hot dog. Not hot dog, but sausage. Medisterkakid. Kittebassertetai. It's not a soft patty. You can feel the texture. It's grainy, but it's really good.
Yeah, it tastes like a sausage, but in a different form, like a meatball sausage. Yeah.
And onto the rib. If you can hear that, that's the top layer.
Ooh. Let's try the actual meat. That's really soft. Mmm.
The top layer is hard, but when I cut through it, it just slides off the bone. It is so soft.
Julaften.
Today it's 24th of December, and in Norway we celebrate Christmas on Christmas Eve. We got Pinnekjott, we got Kalkun, and we got Julebakst. Let's check it out and Merry Christmas.
It's Christmas Eve. The candles have been lit, the fireplace is burning, the house has been cleaned, the table has been set, the tree has been decorated, and the presents are snuggled underneath. There's that Christmas star I was talking about. but something's not quite right. You see, this isn't how Norwegians used to celebrate Yule. Yule was a midwinter festival that lasted several days and featured some unbelievable traditions. Alcohol-fueled Vikings would sacrifice animals and sprinkle their blood onto statues of the gods. Nearby, a designated Yule log would be burned for good luck and to signify the lengthening of the days. If there was a ferocious storm, people would take shelter because it meant Odin and his warriors were hurtling across the sky on the wild hunt, gathering the souls of the dead and anyone unfortunate enough to be outside at the time.
Julebukking
is a tradition where someone from the village would dress up as a goat and go door to door, receiving gifts for protection against spirits and warning children to behave themselves. After Christianity, children began taking part and they would sing Christmas carols in return for food. In the 19th century, the Julebukk evolved from being the recipient of gifts to delivering gifts, in a role similar to Santa Claus. During the 20th century, the international version of Santa Claus began replacing local versions, and unfortunately, all that remains of the once mighty Julebukk is a straw Christmas decoration. If you're a Norwegian watching this, how do you feel about bringing back the OG Julebukk? Let me know in the comments.
Julemiddag.
With the final preparations underway in the kitchen, here's a handful of assorted Christmas facts. There's a regional divide regarding what to have for Christmas dinner. According to matprat.no, Ribbe is favoured in Oslo, the east and mid-Norway, whilst Pinnekjott is favoured in the west and the north. Hashtag Team Ribbe. Nidar estimates that over 40 million marzipan figures are eaten during Christmas, or roughly 7 figures for every person in Norway. In the UK, we leave sherry and mince pies for Father Christmas, which presumably means he should be arrested for drink driving. But here in Norway, they leave
risgrøt
or rice porridge. And finally, although we open our presents on Christmas Day, here they open them straight after dinner.
Christmas Eve buffet, and I'm starting with pinnekjøtt, cured lamb, rotmos, lutefisk, mash, some potatoes.
Very again, nice this Christmas party.
Sauerkraut, ribbe, last one, cranberry sauce, top with sauce.
Ready to eat like a beast.
La seg innskrive sammen med Maria, som var lovet bort til ham, og som ventet barn.
Skål for Tore og Dippen! For at jeg holdt deg en så fin middag.
Det er veldig snart. Det hadde ikke vært det samme uten dere. I hvert fall ikke mødrene våre. Skål for dem.
We're having two sets for Christmas Eve. One of them is caramel pudding and caramel sauce. My brother-in-law is making the ham, which means cranberry cream. Let's see how he makes it.
Caramel pudding
is the Norwegian name for creme caramel, a creamy custard-flavored jelly with a layer of soft caramel at the top.
Multikrem
is a simple dessert made by combining whipped cream, sugar and cloudberries, a tart berry that takes its name from the alpine conditions it can grow in. They're high in vitamin C and have the nickname the gold of the bogs. Multikrem is usually served with
krumkaker,
which can be described as being halfway between a waffle and an ice cream cone.
There's a Christmas tradition in Norway where you actually you can win a prize, julemarsipan. You put an almond piece or just an almond in a porridge. Today we don't have a porridge. We put the almond in multikrem or cardberry cream. It's another very traditional dessert. So the one who gets the almond wins the prize.
And now we're going to sample the Julebakst. This will be Christmas soft drink of choice. Let's give it a go. Quite mild. It tastes like...
It tastes like Yule.
Yeah. Yeah, it tastes like Yule. It tastes like red food coloring. Hints of timber and formaldehyde. Carrot and hibiscus, really. Yeah.
All right, it's time to open the presents and enjoy these lovely baked goods. How are Phillips?
You are my name.
Cheese nice.
Yay!
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, it's rituals.
I just came for the food, man. Hunting socks.
Hunting socks, I'm camping.
These are my Norway socks now.
After unwrapping all those gifts, we need to hydrate with Eplemost. It's from a local town. Eplemost is an apple drink without alcohol. Refreshing.
Romjula.
Which translates to Christmas space, isn't the Norwegian name for the Star Trek race, but a term to describe the period between Christmas and New Year's Eve. Employees are encouraged to take annual leave during this period, reflect upon the year and spend quality time with their friends and family. Now I know what you're thinking. Well, what do Norwegians do for fun? According to Statistics Norway, this chart illustrates the percentage of Norwegians participating in various outdoor activities within a 12-month period. As most of Norway's population is along the coast, if you wander even for a few minutes outside of any settlement, you'll immediately be in the vicinity of a forest, a hill, a mountain, or even a fjord. It's no surprise then that so many Norwegians take an interest in the outdoors. The next chart illustrates the percentage of Norwegians participating in different forms of exercise. I wouldn't say there are any surprises here, but as a Brit, I had to look into the Norwegian football scene. It's Norway's most popular team sport, with 1,822 registered football clubs and almost 400,000 registered players, which means 7.4% of the population plays organised football. 27% of those players are female, including both my wife and her sister.
Stå på ski.
Norwegians have a saying,
Nordmenn født med ski på beina,
which translates to Norwegians are born with skis on their feet. Skiing is a part of Norway's DNA, and children often start learning to ski when they are kindergarten age. The word
ski
comes from Old Norse, and there are Stone Age rock carvings of figures on skis from as early as 3000 BC.
Crazy.
I've put together a timeline of Norway's relationship with skiing, but instead of using stock footage, I've added footage of the first time I went skiing.
Hi.
Hi.
In 1767, the Scandinavian military began organized skiing exercises and races. In 1808 at
Eidsberg,
the first documented ski jump was performed by
Olaf Ry.
In 1843 in
Tromsø,
the first public skiing competition was held. In 1849 in
Trondheim,
the first public recreational ski tour was advertised. In 1861 in
Trysil,
the first ski club was established, and in 1862 the first public ski jumping competition was held. In 1884 in
Trondheim,
the first cross-country ski competition was held. And finally, in 1879, the first documented use of the word
slalom
occurred.
Julelunch
is a tradition where leftovers are served in a buffet alongside a variety of hot and cold foods. You'll find
brød, medisterkaker, kjøttpålegg, hardkokte egg, ostebrett, grønnsaker,
and of course
julebrus.
If you're lucky, you might even have pizza. I tried to take a nap after the heavy meal, but it wasn't meant to be.
Wake up, baby! Wake up!
Wake up! You baby, wake up!
Nyttårsaften.
We're hustling and bustling in this kitchen. We've got to make sure the turkey isn't burnt. It's going to be a disaster if it is, but it looks good. It smells good. My mom likes to make something extra, a side dish next to the turkey, and these are her favorite meatball patties. Meatball patty cakes. Meatball cakes. Whatever.
Norwegians eat turkey on New Year's Eve instead of Christmas, but other than that, it isn't too different to what you'd expect. Friends and family gather, enjoy a homemade meal together, and then grab their thickest winter jackets and head out to watch a fireworks display. Here, the sale of fireworks is restricted to the public. They are only sold from December 27th to the 31st and can only be fired in designated areas between 6 p.m. and 2 a.m. on New Year's Eve. Youngsters take part in
Vorspiel,
which in German literally translates to foreplay, but it's what we would describe as pre-gaming or pre-drinking. In Norway, alcohol is heavily taxed, can't be consumed in public, and is strictly controlled by the government. Grocery stores can only sell alcohol below 4.75% up until 8 p.m. on weekdays, 6 p.m. on Saturdays, and not at all on Sundays or certain holidays. If you want stronger alcohol, you have to go to one of the 315
Vinmonopolet
stores, which close at 6 p.m. on weekdays and 3 p.m. on Saturdays. According to Deutsche Bank, the average price for a pint of beer is £7.32 in Oslo, £5.47 in New York City, and £4.73 in London. With prices like that, you can't blame the youth, can you?
We're on Drammensbrua. It's about to hit 12 o'clock soon. It's midnight here in Drammen, Norway.
As it neared midnight, Drammen came alive with a barrage of fireworks lighting up the sky and the sound of fireworks echoing around the valley. It was impressive that a city with the population of a London borough even had a professional display. But what made it extra special was seeing people contributing to the display with their own fireworks, firing them from their homes or by the side of the river. First Christmas in Norway is one I'll always remember. Although I'd spent a lot of time in Norway, most of it was spent in a small town on the west coast. In Drammen, I was able to experience Christmas through a different lens, trying new food, new drinks, new sports, and taking part in new traditions. We headed home, full of optimism and thoughts about our New Year's resolutions, blissfully unaware of what was to come in 2020. This video series is part of a larger project documenting daily life in Norway, divided into the four seasons. The next part will focus on spring and my experiences staying in a small town on the west coast. Click that subscribe button below so you'll be notified when it comes out, and I'll see you in the next episode.